We'll start today's meeting. Okay, good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Morning, sir.
Morning, sir.
Morning, sir.
Morning, sir. Morning, sir.
Yeah, once again, yeah.
Morning, sir.
Yeah, thank you. We are trying to use English, whether, what's that? We need to force it in the class, yeah? If we don't force it to the academic setting, when we will have this chance to speak English, yeah? Jadi, kita akan coba untuk memaksa diri kita, ya, whether this is receptive or productive, ya, skills using English in this class, ya. But if we have difficulty, sometimes, ya, we can mix it with bahasa. Ya, especially you are the communication science student, related with the communication. So, I really do hope that you have a basic principle of communication science, ya. In the communications, we have cooperative principle. We have several maxims to be done, to be followed. One of them is about politeness principle. You know your context, we know our context. Yeah, but it's okay. Jadi, tidak apa-apa untuk pertemuan pertama, kita akan jelaskan sedikit ya, related with the, what's that, language in general, because I have a responsibility yeah, to accompany you. I rather use a company rather than teaching, yeah, because it will be student-centered learning. I will accompany you to study together, yeah, because we have English for the next level. Ini bukan bahasa Inggris satu lagi, ya, tapi udah English for Communication Science. This is the second level of English. Yeah, in the first meeting, I really do hope that all of you are okay, yeah, in a good condition. We cannot, I'm afraid and unfortunately, yeah, in this semester, we cannot meet each other directly. So I just want to say, yeah, whether it is through the distance learning, you will still keep your health and then your, what is that, spirit in studying. In this early meeting, I will share some principle of our class, yeah, because we are from communication science once again. We need to know about the principle of communication. Yeah, in my major, yeah, because I'm majoring in linguistics. Linguistics is the core of language. Yeah, lebih sharing, jadi sharing sedikit. In learning language, as a language learner, we have two point of view, ya. Prescriptivism. Jadi ada namanya itu prescriptivism. What is prescriptivism? Prescriptivism is based on the rule. Follow the rule. Follow the law. Whether in language, in communication, we have theoretical things, right? Ada banyak-banyak teori. Jadi kita harus bisa mengikuti itu. Tapi di sisi lain, in on other side, we'll see descriptivism, yeah. It should be, it ought be, yeah. Jadi, yeah, we will see the phenomena in our surroundings, yeah, through the context. Whether we have a rule, but we see this condition, we see this nuance, this occasion, this context, we have kind of toleration. We have kind of humanism here. That's why. So I follow that principle, especially in sharing the materials, ya, as a language learner. Jadi nanti kalau sebagai pembelajar bahasa itu kita ada pakem-pakemnya, ya, pakem-pakemnya. For example, the pronunciation. We have received pronunciation, right? Whether some of you tends to have British, some of you tends to have American English, some of you have the word English says, that's okay. But if we found in our society the different pronunciation, that's okay because that's the richness of pronunciation. Jadi ada namanya word English says. Nah, itu dalam pronunciation, belum nanti dalam konteks-konteks lainnya. Jadi selain ada aturan, kita juga bisa fleksibel melihat the reality. Ya, sebagai pengantar ini ya, supaya kita sebagai individu memiliki cara pandang yang khusus terhadap bahasa itu. We cannot see bahasa like the exact science, ya, like a mathematics for example. No, language is different. That's why we see it from prescriptivism and descriptivism. Okay. Jadi itu, misalnya pronunciation R, car, nanti ada yang car, lalu ditertawakan. Nah, itu sudah sifat-sifat yang tidak baik ya menurut pembelajar bahasa or language learner. Jadi kita harus melihat, misalnya dalam salah satu beberapa jurnal, ya, in several states in United States, there are, ya, it's about sociolinguistic, there are several changing. Ya, in several states, the one whose utter R clearly, they show the high social status. In other one, it's so low. But in vice versa, in other states, the one who keep the R are seen by the low social status. Jadi kadang ada yang K gitu, dia menunjukkan high social status. Tapi di tempat lain bisa low social status. Nah, nanti kita bisa pelajari itu sambil jalan, ya. Kalau ada fenomena-fenomena tertentu, ya. Yang jelas itu ya, prescriptivism and descriptivism. Ya, so sorry that's my curiosity related with our personal belief towards the language, ya. Nah, sekarang saya share sebentar, ya, untuk pertemuan pertama, kita mau apa saja? Ya, yeah. In this preliminary, we'll just short. Ya, this is me. Ya, yeah. I'm the lecturer of English Education Study Program. Ya, yeah. In the Faculty of Teachers Training. Ya, yeah. And Education Faculty. I'm majoring in linguistics, so if you know me in the other faculty, yeah, that's me. And then, yeah, currently, yeah, I will accompany you in teaching English for Communication. So what is English for Communication? Yeah, we will see later on. Yeah. So before that one, I will share about what is it about, yeah, in English for Communication Science. What we are going to do. Yeah, itu. In our course, we will discuss kinds of media. Yeah, the communication activity in working situations like dealing with clients, yeah, giving feedback, reading and writing practice based on the authentic media documents later on, and engaging topics, article and journal. Nah, ini nanti di setelah meet ya, article and journal, which is ensure that learning is interesting and motivating. Once again, related with your study program. Kalau bahasa Inggris 1 itu masih pakai English expression yang umum, tapi kalau bahasa Inggris 2, artinya ini, English for Communication, teman-teman semua nanti akan mempelajari major teman-teman, ya, ilmu komunikasi, tetapi dengan ya bahasa pengantar dengan interaksi bahasa Inggris. That's why you learn briefly, ya. Tentu saja tidak semuanya, karena 2 SKS, 3 SKS itu tidak cukup untuk membahas semua bidang di English Communication, maksud saya di Communication Science, ya. Tetapi we just share a bit related with the words that this point, that point, ya. Yeah, and then comes into a journal. Because you need to do this. You need receptive skill. Later on, if you doing a thesis, you will got reference from a board or from international journal articles, conference. Yeah, you can have a good understanding related to it. Yeah, how about the scoring criteria? Mungkin ada di mata kuliah lain di semester ini yang sudah mulai, ya. We have a new curriculum, right? The changing from 2017 and now we have 2021 curriculum. Namanya kan MBKM. Merdeka Belajar Kampus Merdeka. Nah, that's why in MBKM we have OBE, ya, yeah, outcome, ya, yeah, outcome based education. In outcome based education, the scoring is a bit different, ya, yeah, with the common scoring from attendance, from classroom participation, from mid exam, from final exam. No, ya, yeah, it blended become one. Jadi assessment-nya berupa apa? Berupa tiap sub capaian mata kuliah. Nah, nanti setiap sub capaian mata kuliah teman-teman punya persentase sendiri. Nah, di mana kehadiran ya tetap penting, ya. Your attendance are still important. Nah, blended di sini. Then what is your classroom participation? Ya, blended di sini. Cuma ini dibagi rata per sub CPMK, ya. In every sub discussion related with our course. Ya, we have, for example, in this course we have 5 assessment, ya. First assessment, second, third, till fifth. In every assessment we have 20 assessment. Nah, itu adalah scoring kriteria kita. How about the grading? Yeah, we have the common one like the new rector's letters, ya, yeah, SK rektor yang baru. Ini kita pakai yang enggak ada yang upper B, ya, yang we have this one. Okay, it just a brief introduction related with scoring criteria and then the grading. Now what we are going to do during this semester? Yeah, in this first meeting we have course orientation, about syllabus, then communication in general, then warming up activity. But yeah, as your request tadi di awal, mungkin ada yang masih jenuh, ada yang ini, jadi nanti mungkin saya singkat, ya. Okay, then the second one we have a newspaper topic, whether it's quite oldies, ya, yeah, old school, but it's important for jumping stone in discussing another written media. Yeah, jadi sekarang nanti ada we have new media in some website portals, tetapi ya, yeah, but we will start from the traditional thing, ya, yeah, newspaper, whether we have a e-newspaper right now. Ya, yeah, what we are going to do is discussing about cohesion, then closed question, bias, and extra. Nah, next topic, ya, yeah, this is a bit same with newspaper, ya, yeah, the radio. Radio is quite old school, the traditional one, but it's a jumping stone if we want to discuss a bit complicated things related to television and movie or film. That's why we'll still discuss about radio, yeah, about radio programs, the language of radio production, the phrasal used there, and stuff. Then we have the magazines, yeah, as the language of magazine cover, stylistic devices. Nah, nanti tentu saja ada kaitannya, ya. The one that we use in the newspaper, maybe sometimes we use in the magazine because we have the same way, ya. It's the popular news in magazines or in newspaper. Then after the magazines, we are going to discuss about television, ya. Yeah? What is the language of television production? Expressing the modality, vocabulary, and extra. Whether you have already mastered about this, but we will a bit share and refocusing your what's that understanding competence, yeah, and then to make a good performance related with English. Ya, English communication. Jadi teman-teman sudah, tentu saja ini sudah makanan sehari-hari teman-teman. Cuma nanti kita latihannya adalah dengan bahasa Inggris seperti itu. Dan tidak begitu mendalam ya, karena ini on the surface discussion. Karena teman-teman mempelajari ini sampai beberapa SKS ya. Okay, then another one, another authentic topic from the communication and science. We are going to discuss about film. Yeah? The feature of written dialogue started from the script, then we can read the script. Then later on, we interpret after having the perception and analytical things, we can practice this one. Then the technical vocabulary of filming and extra. Till the language connector, the language film review. Okay, then the next we have new media. What is new media? New media, yeah, the one who are currently booming right now, have highly keep in touch with us, the society outside there, yeah, then the technical vocabulary of website, then about the other one, yeah, we have another new media. Yeah, actually if you remember about ASN assessment tadi, meeting 1 sampai 8 itu ya, mid exam salah satu bentuk assessment-nya. Jadi cuma untuk administratif ada UTS, tapi itu salah satu bentuk dari ASN tadi, ya. The first, the second ASN will be here. Nanti yang ketiga kali ada di sini ya. Okay, then next we have the materials after the meet, yeah. We have advertising and marketing. Of course, related with the communication science, yeah. Yeah, how we use our language in reassure someone, convince someone, yeah. That's one. And then language of slogan, then screen advert, then language of advertising, and then marketing, yeah. In advertising and marketing, we have chance, yeah. Additional, this is optional, yeah. But it's subject to change, yeah. In the 11th meeting, we'll spare our time to make a practice, yeah, advertising and marketing practice. Kemudian, yeah, in last topic before we have a project, we will discuss about journal article, yeah, about scientific writing. Yeah, the scientific writing will be started from the easiest one. You will have Indonesian journal, but you need to share it in English. Then the 2 weeks, then the next 2 weeks, we have, yeah, the direct English journal and English sharing. English journal and English sharing. Lalu pertemuan terakhir sebelum UTS, kita akan spare time to prepare your project. Jadi nanti, if you have a project, you will have a longer time for the last week, then ada biasanya ada minggu tenang, ya, yeah, the silent week, and also the DD of the final exam. That's what we are going to do during the semester. Nah, introduction-nya mungkin sebenarnya saya ingin sharing banyak, tetapi tadi ya di awal ada yang memang yang request mungkin ya, yeah, that's anak-anak komunikasi kan sudah tahu ya nonverbal and verbal behavior itu memang the representative of our psychology ya, our inner intention. Itu makanya enggak apa-apa ini nanti dibuat mudah karena pertemuan masih pertemuan pertama ya. What is communication? Tentu saja teman-teman banyak referensi ya. You have several reference. Tapi di sini saya ambil referensi yang jadul dan unik ya. Yang apa? It's very rare ya. Really taken from this one. But I need you to read this ya. Mari kita baca bersama-sama. What is communication? Yeah, communication.
What is communication?
Mind. Yeah, you can read it in your mind. Yeah, yeah. Then please, what's that? Understand and have some synthesis related with this. Yeah, communication is one of those activities that everyone recognizes. But few can define satisfactorily. Communication is talking to one another. It is television. It's spreading information. It is our hairstyle. it is literally criticism. The list is endless. Nah, ini, and once again, there are many definition of communication. It is one of them. Yeah, it is one of them. Nah, what do you mean? Ya, karena banyak sekali, mungkin nanti saya beri kesempatan, tapi yang pertama mungkin, I want to know your, what's that? The beautiful voice, ya. You have beautiful voice here. I want to know and know your competence and performance. We have Mbak Aisyah Nur. Mbak Aisyah Nur, can you share a bit about, kalau di sini ada, it is our hairstyle. What does it mean? In definition of the communication.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
What is again, Mas? What's jaringan in English?
Yeah, it's okay. We have the definition from Fiske, yeah? We have read this before, but my highlight is about it is our hairstyle. Nah, ada it is our hairstyle. What does it mean? Nanti
kind of like our style, maybe.
Our what?
Our style, or I think like, what can I say it? I don't know. It's on my mind, but I can say it.
Oh yeah, it's okay. Yeah, but you know it already. Maybe you can.
Yeah, I know it.
You can type it on the chat box. Tadi ada yang raise hand, tapi masih belum ada namanya ya, iPhone. Maybe you can speak up, but Aisyah can write your opinion in the chat box. Okay, then?
Give me a sec.
Yeah. Okay, the other one? Tadi raise hand tadi siapa? Wanna say something? Just open your mic if you want to say this. Ada? Communication is one of those activity that everyone recognize, but few can define satisfactorily. Yeah, that's the scope of the communication, yeah. Then related with the aim, some are getting done, some are not. Okay. Then about the other field. Yeah. The range is about talking to one another. Yeah, the field, it can be television, it is spreading information. Yeah, that's kind of communication. It is our hairstyle, it is literary criticism. Then, because it has more and more, so it is close by, the list is endless. Then, our focus here, maybe you can share a bit, why it is written it is our hairstyle? Can anyone explain? Not yet? Okay, that maybe another chance ya untuk aktivitas kelas, mungkin di kesempatan yang lain saat kita synchronous seperti ini bisa ada juga ya. Okay, our hairstyle. Television is clearly communication, right? To communicate what is the purpose of the television production, yeah, to others. Then there are so many feedback from the viewers later on, but not directly to the television itself, but to the surroundings. Mbak Hana, wanna say something? No? Okay. Then, like spreading information. Then, hairstyle. Based on Fiske ya, kita mencermati definisinya Fiske ya, bukan definisi komunikasi yang lain karena banyak ya definisi Fiske. Hairstyle mean, for example, if you know kinds of hairstyle, whether the one is bald, the one is dread, the one is kind of reggae style, sometimes it represent themselves, what they like to do, what they believe. Nah, this is communication. About their music reference, ya, misalnya. About the Rasta things. Many things, ya. Because we are in education, we are not feel taboo, ya, to speak that one. Ya. Yeah, we have maybe it's mean hairstyle is the first thing the audience see from us. Okay, ya. Yeah. Physical appearance, ya. Yeah. This is maksudnya Fiske itu mau membicarakan itu physical appearance, ya. Yeah. The people see our non-verbal thing. Itu sudah menunjukkan komunikasi dari kita. We have a beyond of it, we have something to say. We have they have interpretation related with our style. Salah satunya hairstyle. Mas Ahmad Gusti ya, ya like accent in this focus based on Fiske definition is different ya, Mas Ahmad Gusti. Hairstyle is just hairstyle, but it one of the communication. Jadi Fiske itu kritis ini. Definisinya lain daripada yang lain ya, maksudnya dia melihat definisi komunikasi dari sisi-sisi unik sampai ke hairstyle itu kita supaya we have kind of critical thinking that something that we are not aware much, it is also can be a communication thing. Okay, kalau verbal, jelas ya, verbal, it is also communication. Okay, we're going to continue, karena ini hanya pembukaan ya, to refresh our mind. Kita ada beberapa some of the wajah interaction. Thank you, Mas Ahmad. Ya, Mbak Niken, ayo. Mau mengungkapkan sesuatu?
No, sir.
Ya, oke. Okay. Nah. Oh, wait, thank you. Ya? Oh, iya. So sorry for the interruption. Okay, we'll continue. Yeah, tadi if we take an activity, few moments itu, yeah, salah satu kesimpulannya lah communication everyday activity itu dari semuanya in our everyday activity belongs to communication. And then the second one, does communication always done successfully? No. Ya, karena tidak selalu communication itu successfully. Nanti teman-teman bisa lihat teorinya misalnya cooperative principle ya, punyanya bentar. John Austin salah satunya mungkin kan ada the communication can be done but it can be successfully or not. Itulah Fiske juga sama. Ya. Kadang the communication can be started but the end is different ya, the different ending. Nah, lainnya ya. Di pertemuan pertama kita manfaatkan classroom participation. Kita sudah ada beberapa classroom participation. Nah, saya ingin ada yang open mic please explain about this. What do you think about this? What do you think about it? What kind of picture is it? Mas Abraham, want to say something?
Maybe the flag, the red flag.
And the red flag.
Yes.
Yeah. If that is...
Maybe is a red flag.
Pak Es.
Maybe... Yes, sir. Yeah. Let's again. Maybe it's a red flag.
Yeah, thank you, Mas Faiz. Yes. We have Mas Abraham and Mas Faiz. Mas Faiz, I wanna ask you for further question. If it is red flag, yeah, can you guess where is it? What is the purpose of it?
Purpose? Yes. This talk of this tell about this is the flag into.
For example, is it in a peak of a mountain? Misalnya kalau ya, yeah, in every of us have different background, right? Oh, this is a red flag in for example nearby someone's house, or it is in the forest, or it is in the peak of a mountain. Ya, yeah, you can guess, ya. Yeah. Kira-kira di mana ini, Mas Faiz? Where is it? For Mas Abraham?
In the sky.
In the sky.
In the sky.
There is a sky behind of it, yeah. But there is a stick of the flag, yeah. So Yeah, the background is on the sky, but it's still on the ground, yeah. But with the ground, it's still questionable.
Yeah, I'm sorry, sir.
It's okay. I really appreciate your effort, yeah. Yang penting aktif, nah, teman-teman, you have your effort. Yes. Okay, next, yeah. That's we have two sample questions, yeah.
Yes,
what do you think? And then, where is it? Yeah, just guessing. Then we have two also, yeah, two possible question from Mas Faiz and Mas Abraham, yeah. Okay, now another chance, yeah. If I provide you different picture, yeah. So can you answer it clearly, more details, yeah? Mungkin ada yang lain yang mau mencoba to have your classroom participation, interaction in this class.
I think it's warning symbol, Mister.
Mas Panji, warning symbol. Where is it, Mas Panji? Warning for what?
Warning for don't swimming at the beach.
Okay, do not to swim in, on the beach, yeah? This is war, not go outside from that border. Nah. Mas Panji.
Yes, of course.
Why can you say that in details? Why it is different with the previous picture?
Because the flag place at the beach.
Yeah, sorry. The flag place on the beach. Okay, thank you. Yeah, so related with the place means related with the additional information. Nah, ini anak-anak komunikasi sebenarnya sudah tahu ya. Ini hanya just refreshment, right? In the first picture, we have limited information, and then in the second picture, we have more or abundant information related with the people, the setting, the place, yeah, the time and extra, and then the that we have a kind of picture there. It shows that the context mean time, place, situation, nuance and extra. Yeah, for communication purposes, context is important. In the first picture, the answer are very, yeah, banyak, very. But we cannot say this is right, we cannot say this is wrong. And it is also still debatable because of limited context. But here, we can say the answer, oh, this is right, this is wrong. Why? Because we have a complete context. Jadi dalam pragmatics, ilmu makna, nah, nanti kan you have semiotic, semantic, and pragmatic. This context is very important to decide that why we have in reality some of miscommunication, this unsuccessfully communication. That's because of context and understanding. Nah, paham ya? And then the other one, what does this picture implies? Yeah, we have several activities. Mas Panji, thank you. Faiz, Abraham, Mbak Aisyah, and Mas Ahmad. Okay, the other one. Ada yang mau berpendapat? What kind of picture is it?
The Indonesian culture, and then maybe the flag, the yellow flag, the yellow representing flag. The apa bahasanya itu orang meninggal tuh apa ya?
Yeah. Funeral.
Funeral, yes.
Pemakamannya kan orang.
Yes, this way, this way.
Yeah.
Because in the picture it shows someone has died in the best way.
Yeah, someone who passed away. And then this is kind of information, yeah, that this yellow flag means about someone passed away around. Or in specific things, we can say this is about funeral information. Oh, that's funeral. Maybe in this place, it's about yellow color. Another one with white color, right? With white flag, with white cloth, with white fabrics and stuff. Thank you, yeah? Once again, yeah, Mas Babram and Mas Faiz. Now, how about the same color, the same fabric, the same clothes, this one, but it used in a different way. What is the purpose? It is the same with the funeral ceremony. Is it same or different?
The same, like the Indonesian culture, but is the more, gimana ngomongnya?
Gak apa-apa, coba. Nah, ini yang...
Ya, ada di kota lain gitu loh, Pak.
Ya, yeah, a...
yeah, itu.
Pak, tujuannya sama nggak? It has the same...
No, it's different, different.
Ya, yeah. Oke, okay, Mas Abraham. You can get it. The same thing, the same clothes, the same color can imply different meaning, different aim. For example, in Bali, ya. In Bali, the yellow craft here that is surrounds the... Well, we have Ganesha here, ya. The Ganesha statue. Do not represent the funeral or burial ceremony, but it represent the holy place, the sacred place, ya. So different. That's why. Dari yang pertama, konteksnya umum, konteksnya khusus, sudah mengantarkan yang berbeda, ya. Hal yang berbeda. Sekarang, hal yang sama, konteksnya detail sama, spesifik juga, latar belakangnya spesifik, bisa dilihat. Tapi tujuannya beda. Itulah konteks, ya. Konteks. Nah, in knowing this context, ya, kita kan belajar semiotik, kalau teman-teman semiotik di komunikasi, ya. In learning, it can be called semiotic, ya. We will know about sign. Singkatnya saja, ya. Sign can be gathered through the five senses. Whether this is the visual, the smelling, ya, the hearing, then the other five senses, ya. For example, when we ever saw elephant, and we keep it in our concept, in our mind, when we look at the picture that's similar with elephant, we can recognize, oh, this is elephant. Whether this is not the clear picture, this is the abstract picture, for example. Yeah? And also about the smells. Mungkin ini a bread, ya, topi. Ada yang menginjak, pernah menginjak kotoran burung, kotoran ayam. Oh, itu. Tahu itu karena apa? Karena pernah mengalami. That five senses, it happens in our life. Percaya enggak? Nanti ada pemerolehan bahasa ini, the language recognition, it's different each other. Kadang dulu sebelum ada salju, orang Indonesia mungkin belum tahu itu, what is about snow? Karena we cannot understand it in our concept. We didn't ever see through television, maybe at that time there is no television and so on. Nah, itulah sign. So, kalau teman-teman lihat movie, ya, anak-anak komunikasi itu jangan belajar-belajar terus, ya. Belajarnya melalui televisi juga, media, any kind of things, the modernization. We keep in touch in our life. Nah, salah satu dalam movie itu ada yang menceritakan pirates and bandit. Nah, pirates and bandit, mereka itu they took one things, ya, yeah, they wanna take one things, a seal, ya, yeah, sebuah dino seal, itu cap kerajaan, ya, yeah. A seal has been missing when on the journey on the sea, the seal, ya, yeah, the kingdom seal are swollen, ya, yeah, because the ship are wrecked, and then the where is that? The seal are swollen by a whale. Do you know a whale? So, seekor paus. Pausnya merusak kapal kerajaan. Lalu sealnya itu, capnya kerajaan, masuk ke perutnya paus. Lalu there is kind of announcement, a whole of the country, whoever bring back the seal can have where a high position in the kingdom. Jadi semua berlomba-lomba sampai penjahat-penjahat, ya, bandit and pada pirates. When they come, the whale is very specific. The whale has a flag of the kingdom there. Karena saat merusak kapalnya, bendera kerajaannya tercancap di whale-nya tersebut. Then when they looking for this one, ya, yeah, they are together, the bandits and the pirates. Yeah, because the bandits usually live, yeah, on the land, not on the sea, and then the pirates have a different background, different experience. Yeah, they live in the on the sea. When they wanna see a ship, then they wanna go to sea. There is a conversation. Ini conversationnya yang akan saya ceritakan terkait ini ya. The pirates say, then okay, let's go to the sea because it has been swollen by the whale. Then the very strange question right now ya, but at that time this is not strange. The bandit asks. Banditnya itu tanya, what is whale? Whale itu apa? Paus itu apa? Then the pirate said, whale is an animal. Yeah, it is bigger than the house. Ini seekor binatang lebih besar daripada rumah. Then the bandit, because this is kind of comedy movie, yeah, the bandit bully and then hit the pirate so many times. Masa ada binatang lebih besar dari rumah? What do you get from this? Dari sini kita bisa pelajari ya. Nanti, what do you get from this? Kemudian setelah babak belur ya, tanya lagi banditnya ya. Okay, be serious ya. Let's look for this seal, the kingdom seal. Okay, it is on the whale. Once again, what is whale? Whale is a mammal that can breathe from his back. Dipukuli lagi tuh si pirates, karena bandit itu ada di tengah-tengah kontinen. Mereka tidak pernah ada di laut ya. Masa ada binatang kok menyusui mamalia dan dia hidungnya ada di punggungnya. Then ya yeah, for the short story, setelah mereka menemui baru the bandit, oh this is a whale. This is what you have said after several times bullying and hitting ya. Yeah. So when we see about semiotic, this is the reality ya. Kalau kita belum pernah melihat, kita belum tahu apa itu dalam our mental concept. Ini sama. If we have ever hear, ever touch, ever smells, we never know about it. Itulah kenapa nanti setiap mahasiswa, setiap teman-teman, ya, setiap kita itu beda background knowledge-nya. Jadi itu sangat penting untuk komunikasi dasarnya. For example, teman-teman KKN, teman-teman apa, nanti dengan misalnya ibu-ibu PKK bilang, oh, silabus kita untuk mengajar ibu-ibu. Mereka bilang, silabus itu apa? Makanan apa? What kind of the things is silabus? What is it? Nah, itu nanti teman-teman bisa memakai teori komunikasi yang menurunkan levelnya, menyesuaikan dengan para pesertanya dan sebagainya. So, the communication theory is important. That's why we learn, try to refocusing your understanding related with first about language recognition ya itu. Ya. Yeah. Okay, that's why saya tak silent dulu ya. Okay, we have interesting chat here. In my city is different. We use white flag. Yeah, in several places. Nah, nanti white represent peace. Yeah, kadang. Yeah, that's not wrong. That's not correct. Yeah, Mas Havi and Mas Abraham communication here in the chat is quite okay. Yeah, this is the reality. Karena apa? Salah satu yang kita garis bawahi nanti adalah ini social convention. Ya, yeah. What is social convention? Social convention itu kesepakatan masyarakat. Ada nanti kita akan tahu dari sign and symbol. Ya. Okay. Kesepakatan masyarakat di suatu tempat itu putih warnanya, di beberapa tempat kuning. Ya. Oke, okay. Komunikasi lainnya definisinya ini gampang. Sources, decoding, encoding, ya. Yeah. Like a computer, ya. Yeah. In encoding something, decoding something. Makanya kalau kita punya five sense, misalnya belum tahu bahasa Arab, tapi encodingnya kodenya itu adalah with Arabic language, we cannot make a decoding. Nah, that's why communication can be successfully, can be not. Nah, dalam komunikasi, kita harus juga penting melihat ini. Mungkin teman-teman tahu gambar apa ini? This is kind of child drawing, ya. Mas Mulia Dharma ini, yang sudah on cam, on sound. Want to say something? Atau teman-teman yang lain? What kind of picture is it?
The bird maybe?
The bird and?
And rabbit.
The cat, I think cat and rabbit.
Yeah. Okay. All of you are correct. Ya. Tadi ada yang perempuan tadi, Mbak siapa?
The puppy, maybe. Puppy.
The puppy. Okay. Nah ini, yeah. Cat and rabbit, and then this one, yeah, the chick and the bird.
Yeah. The chick. That's what I meant. I'm sorry, sir.
Yeah, but it is not figurative language, ya, Mas Abraham. This is about the literal meaning of chick, ya. Karena nggak apa-apa. Kalau dalam bahasa Inggris, bebas di sini, ya. Kita belajar academic thing. Slang itu banyak digunakan di apa, kita harus tahu, ya. Chick can mean kind of negative, but can be meaningful here as an animal. The other one in figurative language, ya. Okay. Yeah. We can see this is like us. We can see thing, misalnya chick tadi untuk sesuatu yang negatif atau yang positif tergantung dari ini teorinya, ya. Process of getting information, dasar-dasarnya dulu teman-teman refresh aja, ini teman-teman sudah tahu, cuma refresh. In getting information by Kaedler, we have perception. So that's why ada 100 orang itu mungkin ada hampir 100 perception, ya, different perception. It is about different point of view. Then each of you identify by your different perception and comes into your interpretation. Jadi kalau memilih kata, in your word choice, perception itu artinya tahap awal saat teman-teman memperolehnya, sudut pandangnya. Kalau interpretasi itu artinya tahapan yang teman-teman sudah mengidentifikasi, ya. You have identification process, then it's called by interpretation. Kenapa interpretasinya beda-beda? Karena ada persepsi yang berbeda-beda. Oke. Okay. Ya, yeah, that's things that need to be considered. Ya. Okay. Nah, itu media nanti bisa saya share di e-learning, ya. Ini hanya untuk ini. Sekarang warming up ada banyak, tapi saya ini satu saja, ya. Untuk penutup classroom activity kita, karena pertemuan pertama. Nanti kalau full, ya, teman-teman ada tadi sudah get bored, for example, ya, di awal, nggak apa-apa. Mungkin siapa? Kita sudah punya beberapa activity, ya. Mas Mulia, Mas Panji, Mas Faiz, Mas Abraham, Mbak Aisyah, Mas Ahmad. Can anyone answer this very random questions, ya? Ini hanya untuk classroom activity. Warming up. To encourage you to speak. Ya, please speak up. Can you tell me what occur twice in a week, once in a year, but never in a day?
Letter E.
Ya, Mbak Isha. Okay, thank you. I got it. Then the other chance, mungkin teman-teman yang lain punya pendapat yang lain. Maybe the rest, have a different answer, different opinion. What occur twice in a week, once in a year, but never in a day. Mm-hmm. Anyone? Okay, the closing discussion, maybe I will ask Mas Rafli Oli. Mas Rafli Oli, are you here? Can you hear me? Yeah. Not here?
Yeah.
Can you answer this one? Do you have the same answer with Mbak Aisyah or do you have different answer?
Ya, nggak ngerti mas.
Punya jawaban yang sama dengan Mbak Aisyah atau beda? Ini dibaca ya. Walk a girl twice in a week, once in a year.
Can you tell me?
A girl itu muncul. Twice itu dua kali ya. Once itu sekali. Never itu tidak pernah.
Can you tell me what occurs twice in a week, once in a year, but never in a day? Apa ya artinya?
Apa yang muncul dua kali in a week?
Oh, yeah.
Once in a year, but never in a day. Apa itu?
Apa ya? Nggak tahu mas.
Tahu, oke. Okay. Tadi sudah dicoba Isa, mungkin ada yang lain.
Oh iya. What a cool.
Yeah, that's critical thinking ya. Sudah dapat informasi juga ya. Okay, what a girl twice in a week. Jadi dua kali. There is no instruction to translate it all ya. Tadi thank you ya. Mas Rafli Oli. Oke.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, there is no direct instruction to translate it, but just read it and then you can synthesize in your mind, make identification. Nah, critical thinking ya. What occur twice in a week, yang dua kali kalau we think about activity, there is no activity because it's rejected from the three agreement. We have three agreement, right? Twice in a week, once in a year, but never in a day. Itu kalau dimasukkan satu-satu, rejected. Nah, yang enggak, sudut pandang tadi, you have certain perception, right? Ada persepsinya. Kalau ini bukan activity, ini tentang tulisannya. It's about the letter. Walk a girl, dua kali in a week. Week itu, tulisan week itu apa yang dua kali? Once dalam year itu apa yang sekali? Tapi D itu nggak ada, nggak muncul. Oh, berarti the letter E. Nah, itu tadi. Itu adalah praktek, salah satu, walaupun ini intermezzo question, tapi ini salah satu indirect practice from what is Kaedler said, ya. The perception, identification, then interpretation. To get the appropriate answer, you need to have perception from the letter that is found for many occur here. Itu tadi ya, sebagai closing. Okay, thank you very much. If you have question, please you may do so. If not, we'll close this meeting. Yeah. Bentar, saya sambil menunggu ya, saya akan ini presensi dulu sebentar. While waiting for this, maybe if you have a question related to our first meeting, you may.
Maybe you, Mr. Agustinus, tell us about the tips. Bagaimana kita bisa belajar bahasa Inggris selagi di apa di kelas ini gitu loh Pak.
Oh ya, oke okay, Mas Abraham ya. Oke, okay, saya sudah selesai mempresensi. Oke, okay, related with Mas Abraham questions ya. I will show you kinds of book ya in a bookstore. Ada yang bilang gini, mahir berbahasa Inggris 8 jam. Do you believe it? That's bullshit, ya. Yeah. Kita gunakan langsung kata-kata seperti itu because this is nonsense to study English just for hours. Ya, it days, it weeks, it months. Ya, tergantung levelnya nanti kalau memang belajar bahasa Inggrisnya level apa, that's okay, Pak. In mastering English in a certain hours, it's nonsense. Ya, related with Ma Abraham, ya. Kalau dalam teori ini juga aplikasinya kan teori dari aplikasi ya. Ada itu language learning sama language acquisition. Nah, penutupnya ya pertanyaan Mas Abraham ini, nggak apa-apa, belum kita. Language learning itu ya di kelas, di offline, online seperti ini. I will use bahasa. Jadi kalau language learning itu sesuatu yang kita pelajari secara sadar. Kadang tergantung teknik yang digunakan kan. Kadang ada menggunakan drilling ya. Drilling itu oldies, old school banget ya, cara lama. Tetapi di hal-hal yang tertentu, misalnya untuk memperbaiki pronunciation itu perlu. Jadi jangan tadi receptive skill sama descriptive point of view-nya itu harus kita sesuaikan. Jangan terlalu cepat menganggap wah itu jelek, ini baik, ini jelek. Tidak. Kalau dalam bahasa itu semua bisa diambil hikmahnya. Kadang drilling yang dianggap kuno itu bisa untuk meningkatkan vocabulary kita dalam pronunciation misalnya. Nah, hal-hal seperti itu kan teknik-teknik macam-macam gaduh-gaduh itu dipelajari secara sadar. Nah, kalau belajar bahasa itu teorinya malah jangan language learning. Language learning itu hanya administratif saja. Tapi language acquisition. Acquisition. Apa itu language acquisition? Itu pemerolehan bahasa. Mengadopsi dari semua bahasa sebenarnya. L1, L2. L1 itu bahasa ibu. Misalnya teman-teman jawab dalam hati ya, bahasa ibunya apa? Kalau saya bahasa Jawa. Kenapa bahasa Jawa? Karena saat saya lahir, saya dibesarkan orang tua saya dulu, itu lingkungan saya, semuanya mayoritas bahasa Jawa. Jadi, my first language is bahasa Jawa. Nah, dalam bahasa Jawa itu tidak ada, saat mempelajari bahasa ibu, itu tidak ada pelajaran, ini subjek, ini verb, ini predikat, ini grammarnya seperti ini, tidak. Nah, dalam belajar bahasa itu seharusnya seperti itu, seperti pemurlehan. Jadi, bawah sadar. Jadi, apa yang kita pelajari tadi, misalnya menonton film, percakapan sehari-hari, di luar kelas, itu harus kita paksakan memakai bahasa Inggris supaya secara tidak sadar kita sudah membudayakan diri kita untuk belajar bahasa Inggris. Jadi kalau kita sadar misalnya ada yang satu hari itu membaca kamus 2 lembar, 3 lembar, kali berapa hari? Ya, 1 hari, 2 hari, hafal.
Selmian malah duduk.
1 minggu, 2 minggu, hafal.
Nanti kalau kenapa kita?
Sorry ya.
Mana itu? Rijus katanya. Yus. Coba ke sini deh.
Nah, Pak, ini dulu. Oke, yang Mas Abraham dulu ya. Jadi, tapi in our long-term memory, kalau jangka panjang, nanti sudah gampang hilang. Nah, makanya dalam belajar itu, kita lebih baik bawa sadar through conversation, misalnya listening music tadi ya, misalnya ada lagunya Evanescence, Call Me When You Are Sober. Ada lagunya, ada liriknya, teman-teman ini. Sober itu apa ya? Oh, sober itu cari kamus. Itu dari konteks, itu akan lebih masuk ke long-term memory kita. Gitu. Nah, itu dibandingkan dengan belajar secara rigid ya, dalam learning seperti itu. Kita mengadopsinya Mas Abraham ke pemurlehan bahasa. Seperti anak-anak, kalau secara psikologis itu kan ada golden age. Jadi, the first year, second year, itu belajarnya itu. Lalu, grammar, tata bahasa itu bukan nomor 1, tapi nomor sekian. Jadi yang penting kalau kita belajar bahasa, masa ada anak balita ya, mama, baba, nggak boleh, itu harus mama, papa, bukan baba. Nah, tidak ada koreksi langsung seperti itu. Jadi yang penting kita produk dulu ya Mas Abraham dan teman-teman. Lalu kesalahan itu nggak apa-apa. Namanya tadi saya sudah pesan nih, sebagai language learner atau language teacher itu nggak boleh langsung ngejudge, langsung feedback. Misalnya ada temennya yang sedang belajar, oh itu salah, nggak. Nah itu namanya disrupt the motivation. Nah misalnya teman-teman nanti praktek ada setengah jam ngobrol sama temennya, evaluasinya setelah terakhir, setelah misalnya debate, bahas tentang topik misalnya coki dan tretan muslim. Nah misalnya gitu. In English. Lalu tiba-tiba baru 2-3 kalimat langsung direvisi. Oh no, that's need to be wrong. The grammar need to be verb too because it explain. Nah, itu cara belajar yang judging ya. Enggak, nanti yang baru mau create, dia sudah mau ngomong apa ya saya tadi ya. Nah, seperti itu. Selain itu, kalau dia have low motivation, dia sudah, ah, sama temennya ya, mending. Ah, lo rese nih. Ya, gitu. Ya, kalau sama temennya, kalau seseorang yang disungkan, nih, misalnya sama gurunya atau lecturer, wah, takut aku ngomong ke ini, langsung dikomentari ini. Ya, saya ngomong ini, dipatahkan ini. Tidak. Jadi, tadi, seperti anak-anak belajar aja. Jadi, kadang kita tahu kalau ada subjek predikat nanti setelah kelas 2 SD, 3 SD, baru ada feedback dari gurunya. Oh, susunan kata yang benar seperti itu. Seperti Mas Abraham, jadi makanya di awal tadi saya bilang, sampaikan ya, pemilihan katanya, sampaikan. Kalau di kelas ini kita harus paksakan. We must to force in English. Kalau enggak, di konteks mana lagi? Misalnya saya keluar dengan keluarga sudah bahasa Indonesia. Teman-teman di kampus ke kantin sudah bahasa Indonesia. Nah, kalau wanna say English ya, you need to create your own atmosphere. Nah, beda dengan kita kan EFL, English for language learner-nya itu foreign language. Kalau Singapura, Malaysia itu ESL, second language. Jadi dia di kantor kadang sudah resmi pakai ada bahasa Inggrisnya, presentasi dan lain-lain. Jadi our environment support as much itu, dan tidak bisa instan itu ya, sedikit-sedikit seperti itu. Oke, okay, I hope I can answer your questions.
Ini ada. Thank you for your information, sir.
You are welcome. Yeah. From Harvey, yeah. Can I ask you a question, sir? Do you prefer use British accent or American accent when you speak English? American, because it's simpler. Yeah. Well, they have. But my accent is universal word English is, yeah. I explain you about what's that? Descriptivism and prescriptivism. Ada yang namanya receive pronunciation. Receive pronunciation itu standard English. Ada yang standard Englishnya British, American, and the last one is the Australian ya. Yeah. Australian kadang mereka sering ejek-ejekan karena bangga budaya ya kadang. Nah, tapi satu dengan yang punya kekhasan sendiri. Tidak salah, tidak benar. Jadi, so we need to have that things too. Jadi sebelum ke accent, nanti teman-teman kalau mau receive pronunciation silakan, you can follow the British or the American or the Australian pronunciation, or if you blend it and mix it, as long as it for the communication purposes, it's okay. Because kalau teman-teman nanti lihat di YouTube atau apa yang versi singkat ya, sejarah bahasa Inggris, the English history, ya, history of English language, itu mulai dari British ke American, lalu ke Australia yang sebagai dalam tanda kutip negara buangan ya, dulu untuk tambang, untuk membuang tahanan, dan lain-lain, itu kan memunculkan aksen-aksen. Sampai ke Indian accent, ya, Southeast Asia accent, Japanese accent, itu namanya word English. Nanti tergantung dengan aksen bahasa ibu kita, itu nggak salah. Ya. Sejauh itu berterima ya, tentu saja pronunciation-nya tidak melenceng sekali, tetapi accent, accent itu dialect. Ya. Jadi can be vary. Ada lagi sebelum kita tutup? Jadi semoga bisa memperkaya apa point of view teman-teman.
Excuse me, sir.
Mbak Mariska.
I have one question. Because I joined late. If we meet again, sir, are we can you speaking English? But if we don't know something, say, may I mix the language Indonesian?
Yeah, thank you, yeah, Mbak Mariska. Yes. You may, yeah. Because first thing, we need an effort. Yeah, in this class, because you are not English study program students, right? So the level of using English have a different. So the important thing for language learner is the effort. I will mix it like what you said, yeah. I will mix it in bahasa. Usaha itu kalau dalam prioritas kelas saya utamakan. You have your effort. Then the other one can follow. It mean, yeah, tentu saja tanpa effort, yeah, without an effort, we cannot do nothing because this is language class. Without practicing, without receipt, kita mau ngomong bahasa Inggris tapi nggak pernah dengar input Inggris, nggak mungkin. Seorang anak pengen anaknya bahasa Jawa tapi ngomongnya bahasa Inggris terus, ya nggak bisa. Nah, that's why we need to merge ourselves into English environment. Tapi pertanyaan ke Mbak Mariska tadi boleh, we can mix in using English. Whether maybe in our mind at that time suddenly we lost memory related with this vocabulary, we can change it with English, with Indonesia, with bahasa.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, Mbak Mariska. And then for next meeting, we will blend between synchronous and asynchronous. Yeah, sometimes we will have this synchronous meeting like this, and sometimes we will change into a kind of asynchronous. It means guided. I will provide a video and then materials, discussions on the e-learning website. And then another one, we change the setting. We will have synchronous meeting like this. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
You are welcome, Mas Panji and others. I hope we can see it again, whether this is synchronous or asynchronous next week, yeah, in the next materials related with newspaper. Whether this is quite all this, once again, but this is needed for us, for our basic layer. Thank you very much. I hope you keep yourself in healthy condition. Semangat, tetap ya. Dan jaga kesehatan. Okay, goodbye.
Thank you very much. Goodbye, sir.